So Q-Tango is what brought us here. And of course, Olga's first question is, what are we gonna play? And you guys all know the answer, right? I don't know. So I think, let's do a, oh yeah, I need one of those. So you'll see the bandoneon players putting something on their leg. What they are doing is putting a piece of cloth there so that they don't rip their wounds. Because the bottom of the bandoneon, can you show them the bottom of your bandoneon? It was held together by nails on the bottom. So to be a famous bandoneon player back in the 30s, the one thing you needed was a bandoneon and a suit. And of course, most people could only afford one suit, right? So there was always that risk. What will I do if I damage the suit? Okay, so we're gonna do La Ultima Copa. We're gonna do it too slowly. Because we don't need microphones. Do we? No. Always listen to the Russian when she tells you. No. Okay. So La Ultima Copa, the song is about a guy who treats a woman horribly and then says, that's it, she left me because I treated her horribly. And now I'm gonna drink myself to death and it's her fault. So all of you ladies have been there and I'm sure you've seen this happen where a man blames you for all of his shortcomings. Most tangos are about that. Incidentally, they're generally written by men. The Me Too movement had not quite happened just yet. People were celebrating the fact that they treated people horribly and then wrote songs about them. However, we have inherited these beautiful songs, and we will sing it and play it together. Oh, and of course, Yuki is going to play on the noun with us. Do you know what you're playing? Yeah? So Yuki's English has improved dramatically over the last few years, but sometimes we ask her, and she says yes. It's like, okay, great. And then Olga says, did you understand? She says, no. You can get into a lot of trouble that way, Yuki.
Yeah.
Thank you very much. So we're going to invite the full orchestra up now for a couple of numbers. So when we do this, we have several ensembles, and what we do is we get together and we try to make one larger ensemble. So it's quite challenging because, well, for instance, Yuki was just reading this and we have no idea what we're going to do together. And earlier we actually practiced these pieces a couple times, and that seemed like plenty.